escadron a été le premier à utiliser les Spitfire dans le cadre d'opérations canadiennes. Au total, 14 escadrons de l'aviation royale canadienne ont adopté le Spitfire. Parmi ceux-ci figuraient 10 escadrons de chasseurs ou de chasseurs-bombardiers basés en Europe, dont 3 formaient une escadre de chasse et de reconnaissance de l'aviation royale canadienne et une autre, le 417e, exploitait des chasseurs-bombardiers en Afrique du Nord, en Sicile et en Italie.
We'll recover the Spitfires, and as you can hear to the right, the RAF Red Arrows are starting engines. Bottom end is those engines crank. We're getting closer to Red Arrow time. And here come the Spitfires.
Oui, Rick, d'hier à aujourd'hui, alors qu'on récupère nos deux Spitfire Mark 9 de la Deuxième Guerre mondiale, vous avez maintenant sur votre droite le son des Hawk T1, appareil de formation utilisé par la Royal Air Force et qui, aux commandes des pilotes d'élite des Red Arrows, vont vous éblouir dans les prochaines minutes dans le ciel de Gatineau, Ottawa. Belle occasion de prendre une photo. Les Red Arrows en premier plan et les Spitfire, un par-dessus l'autre, un au sol et un à basse altitude. Rob Collins aux commandes de son Mark 9 de la formation Collins qui s'en donne à cœur joie. Rob qui disait que malheureusement, selon lui, il pilote plus un bureau qu'un avion. Et j'ai l'impression qu'aujourd'hui, il s'est donné liberté de s'éclater dans le ciel de Gatineau.
And of course, flying high cover for Mike Potter. As he recovers and taxis in, be sure and give our pilots a huge wave. They're not going to be able to hear that applause or appreciation again, especially over the jet engines. We'll let them know it's a great thing they're doing to keep these airplanes flying so that the stories are always told so that we will never forget. And that's what it's all about. Spitfires.
Alors qu'on va récupérer le Spitfire de la Fondation Collins, Mike Potter qui tout doucement nous revient aux commandes de ce Mark 9 au sol. Il faut être extrêmement prudent dans les déplacements au sol d'un Spitfire. La queue de l'avion est extrêmement légère et si par inadvertance on donne trop de gaz, la queue peut se soulever très rapidement, dépasser la ligne d'horizon et là vous êtes dû pour un changement d'hélice sur un Spitfire de la Deuxième Guerre mondiale, ce qui coûte extrêmement cher. Le nez de l'appareil est très, très long et cache complètement la vue du pilote. Et c'est pour ça qu'il, au sol, oscille de droite à gauche. Même au décollage, il faut toujours garder la queue du Spitfire le plus bas possible afin d'assurer un bon dégagement de la grande hélice. Regardez l'hélice au devant de l'appareil qui est immense. Wow, quelle belle occasion de prendre au passage un Spitfire avec les Hawk de la Royal Air Force en arrière-plan.
The history, the connection, of course, especially through aviation between Britain and Canada, celebrated here today, culminating with the RAF Red Arrows in just a few moments. As our Spitfires shut down, we'll move from yesterday to today. An experience British-made Hawk jet, and the RAF's best of the best, the Red Arrows.
On les salue au passage, mesdames, messieurs, bien haut avec les chapeaux, pour les laisser savoir qu'on a apprécié de voir non pas seulement un, mais deux Mark 9 Spitfire dans le ciel de Gatineau. L'équipe au sol, les Blues maintenant, sont en mouvement, ce qui veut dire que dans les prochaines minutes, nous allons voir 9 de ces appareils rouges flamboyants, des Red Arrows, être en mouvement et se lancer dans le ciel et préparer leur présentation. La toute première en sol nord-américain. Premier passage lors d'un spectacle aérien complet dans cette tournée nord-américaine de l'équipe des Red Arrows. Ici, pour vous, à Gatineau, Ottawa, leur premier arrêt officiel. Regardez-les au passage, ils nous saluent, mesdames et messieurs, les pilotes des Red Arrows, avec les leaders qui arborait le drapeau du Canada il y a quelques secondes.
Ready to go, Michel, and I can't wait.
Vous n'êtes pas le seul, Rick. Moi non plus. On sent l'énervement, on sent la palpitation monter. Écoutez, c'est pour moi la première fois que j'ai l'occasion de voir évoluer les Red Arrows. Je pense que la plupart des gens dans la foule également, vous êtes ici pour pouvoir voir cette équipe d'élite de l'aviation royale s'élancer dans le ciel. Donc, j'ai bien hâte de voir la présentation. Et on nous dit que c'est une présentation haute en couleur et en sensation.
Oh, it sounds like the audio.
The impressive lineup of jets, of course, getting turned around at the end of the runway as they get ready to take off. Soon we'll be introducing you to Adam. He's going to tell us all about what you're about to see.
That's good.
This very dynamic and precise jet demonstration coming up from the RAF Red Arrows.
Effectivement, les Red Arrows qui vont, lors de leur première demi de spectacle, faire des formations de groupe, les 9 appareils. Et par la suite, au lieu de faire une présentation solo, ils se scindent en 3 groupes. Et durant la deuxième partie du spectacle, chacun des groupes fait des présentations solo. Vous allez voir, c'est quelque chose de très inusité à laquelle on n'est pas vraiment habitué ici, en Amérique du Nord.
Of course, the red, white and blue smoke too that is used by the team, one of their trademarks. They look terrific today, earlier over Parliament Hill, already some of the photographers. And there are many of them from across the nation and, in fact, around the world here to capture these moments, presenting some incredible photographs over Parliament Hill and the War Memorial, too, downtown Ottawa.
Effectivement, Rick, ce matin, on avait une célébration avec les Spitfire et Les Red Arrows qui ont passé au-dessus du Parlement également et qui ont ébloui, comme vous le disiez, il y a des photographes qui sont venus un peu partout à travers le monde, je pense, pour avoir un cliché mémorable de ce passage des Red Arrows qui nous reviennent au Canada après une très, très, très longue absence. Donc, on les voit tourner. C'est les gens qui voient complètement à l'extrême droite. Les neuf appareils vont se positionner pour faire un décollage. 3x3 ou 2x2, dépendamment de la largeur de la piste ici à l'aéroport. On ne pourra pas faire un décollage, j'ai l'impression, des neuf appareils de front. Mais on va partir en séquence et on va se rejoindre très rapidement dans le ciel pour pouvoir se rejoindre, faire ce qu'on appelle le brassage, vérifier que tout à l'intérieur est très sûr. Est-ce qu'on sera sûr et est-ce qu'on sera satisfait? On demanderait au directeur de vol l'autorisation de se lancer dans sa présentation.
Camera's ready.
Mesdames et messieurs, les gens bleus, ce qu'on appelle les blues, l'équipe au sol des Red Arrows.
Les personnes qui reviennent dans l'air esprit. Vous allez les applaudir, ce sont vivants et ses femmes, les tiennes, alors, les Red Arrows, les blues, mesdames et messieurs.
Et en français maintenant, bonjour tout le monde, mon nom est Angel. Nous sommes ici à l'aéroport exécutif Gatineau, Ottawa, et au Gatineau, Ottawa 2, et nous allons parler maintenant des Red
They go. A quick shakeout formation. Shortly, we'll introduce you to Adam as they are about to commence.
On va se regrouper, s'assurer que tout est bien sécure à l'intérieur des appareils Hawk T1. Une fois qu'on sera satisfait, Adams Collins prendra le micro pour la présentation de cette équipe 2019, mesdames et messieurs. Première présentation nord-américaine pour vous, à Gatineau et à Ottawa, des Red Arrows.
Adam Collins, ladies and gentlemen, please make him feel welcome here from the RAF Red Arrows.
Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. My name is Squadron Leader Adam Collins. I am Red 10, the supervisor, with the Royal Air Force Aerobatic Team, the Red Arrows! Well, it is our absolute pleasure to be here in Gatineau this afternoon. It is my pleasure, my privilege to talk you through the Red Arrows display today. I will describe the maneuvers to you. I will let you hear some of Red One's radio transmissions and give you some background information on the team and the pilots.
L'année dernière, quand l'année 2018 a été très importante pour la Royal Air Force, alors qu'on a célébré le centenaire en tant que première force aérienne indépendante au monde, les thèmes de ce centième de la Royal Air Force ont été commémorés, célébrés, inspirés, et ce sont tous les pertinents cette année qu'ils ont encore dans le cadre de cette activité, commémoré, célébré et inspiré. Voilà ce que l'on veut faire pour vous aujourd'hui.
Well, 2018 was a very significant year for the Royal Air Force as we celebrated our centenary as the world's first independent air force. This year, there are very many other anniversaries which we'll talk about during the show, but the themes of RAF 100 were to commemorate, to celebrate, and to inspire. And those themes are just as true this year as they were last year.
Cool,
and our aim in the Red Arrows is to inspire as many of you in the audience as we can, both young and old, to follow your dreams.
Cette année 2019, on célèbre plusieurs autres anniversaires, dont l'alunissage d'Apollo 11 et le premier vol du Concorde. Cependant, le plus important pour nous est le 75e anniversaire du département du jour J et de la bataille de Normandie. Sur les 150 000 soldats impliqués dans ce débarquement du jour J, plus de 14 000 étaient des Canadiens, avec qui nous poursuivons aujourd'hui un solide partenariat militaire. Les Red Arrows ont eu le privilège de prendre part à des événements commémorant le débarquement du jour J plus tôt cet été dans le sud de l'Angleterre et en Normandie, en France.
Well, this year, CSAS celebrates several more anniversaries, including the 50th anniversary of the Apollo moon landings and the 50th anniversary of the first flight of Concorde. However, the most significant anniversary this year is the 75th anniversary of the D-Day landings and the Battle of Normandy. Of the 150,000 troops involved in the D-Day landings, over 14,000, of course, were Canadians. And today, we continue our strong military partnership. Earlier in the year, the Red Arrows were privileged to take part in several events commemorating the D-Day landings, both in the UK and in Normandy.
La Royal Air Force a toujours été fière d'être innovante et inclusive, avec des opportunités basées sur le mérite plutôt que sur les antécédents. Le sexe, la race ou la religion. La Royal Air Force a été le premier service britannique à ouvrir tous les rôles aux femmes et il figure parmi les 50 meilleurs employeurs pour les femmes selon le magazine Times. La Royal Air Force est fière d'être le meilleur grand employeur d'apprentis du Royaume-Uni, offrant une opportunité de classe mondiale sans égale.
The RAF has always been proud of being an innovative and inclusive service, and the opportunities that we have are based on merit rather than background, gender, or religion. The RAF was in fact the first of the UK services to open all roles up to both men and women, and we've been recently voted as one of the Times top 50 employers of women. We're also very proud of our apprenticeship schemes, with young people joining from science, technology, engineering, and maths, offering a world-class opportunity that is second to none.
Okay, sometimes you have to recycle the...
Ladies and gentlemen, it's about time. Please put your hands together for the Royal Air Force Aerobatic Team, the Red Arrows! Red One leading the formation over in big battle. The red, white and blue smoke painting the Union flag over Gatineau. As the aircraft pull up, Red One calling them into short diamond.
Hello, Tom.
Over the top of the loop at 3,500 feet, Red One leading short diamond about to twist the aircraft around to the right.
To the right, now. Hold.
Red One speaking with a very metronomic cadence. The pilots are reacting to his voice and the tempo of his commands rather than the movement of his aircraft. And that's how we keep those shapes symmetrical and those lines very straight. Well, it's time for the first of our historic formation shapes as the smoke comes back on. Red One has called the aircraft into Apollo formation. Representing the Apollo landing craft and celebrating the 50th anniversary of the moon landings. In from the right-hand side is Apollo. The lights come on towards us. The smoke is about to come on for the Apollo roll. Over the aircraft go at 2,500 feet. Leading the formation, Red One, Squadron Leader Martin Pert. He's a former Harrier and Typhoon pilot. He's instructed on the Hawk and is in his second year as the team leader. On the right of him is Red Two, Flight Lieutenant Damo Green. Damo has previously flown the Hawk as an aggressor pilot. He then flew the Typhoon on the front line as in his first year on the team. Well, those of you who were in Ottawa earlier on will have seen the next formation already. This, again, is celebrating the next of our anniversaries. The smoke comes on, the aircraft sliding back into position as Red One prepares to fly past in Concorde. Concorde, of course, an engineering triumph combined with a beautiful design. Flown by both the French and the British, its last flight several years ago now, but this formation commemorating that first flight 50 years ago. In from the left-hand side, Reds 8 and 9, looking like the engines underneath Concorde, the smoke about to come on. Red One pulls the nose of Concorde up to the vertical, the aircraft about to change formation in the Concorde loop. Over the top, Reds 8 and 9 sliding to the outside of the formation as they transition to Signet. Left of Red One is Red Three, Squadron Leader Mike Bowden. Mike is a former Harrier and Tornado pilot. He's previously instructed on the Hawk and is in his fifth season on the team. As Signet moves off to our right-hand side, Red One calling the aircraft into our technically most difficult formation position. We now have six aircraft forming up in line abreast. Red 6 and 7 tucking in behind. It's time for Phoenix. Red 1's metronomic voice commands, keeping those formation shapes symmetrical. The smoke on and off, time to his commands. As Phoenix comes in from our left-hand side, it's time for some more red, white, and blue smoke in Phoenix. Again, on the right-hand side of Red One is Red Four, another new pilot for this year, Flight Lieutenant Gregor Ogston. Gregor has previously flown the Harrier and the Typhoon. He's also instructed on our more modern version of the Hawk, and he is in his first year on the Red Arrows. The smoke comes back on as the aircraft transition from Phoenix into the next of our historic formations. The aircraft represented here has a special place in the hearts of all of us in the UK, and I know everybody here in Canada. Its contribution to Bomber Command in World War II was second to none. Coming in from the right-hand side, it's time for Lancaster. As Lancaster rolls upside down, we've got the smoke trailing from the wingtips and the tail. On the left wingtip of Lancaster is Red 5, Squadron Leader Steve Morris. Steve has previously flown the Harrier and the Tornado. He's also instructed on the Hawk T2, and he rejoins the team for the 2019 season. Well, ladies and gentlemen, as Lancaster moves off to our left-hand side, it is time for one of our most popular maneuvers of the display. This one again is representing an aircraft flown for many years by the Royal Air Force, retiring this year to be replaced by the F-35. Several of us on the team have flown the aircraft that's about to be represented. Get your cameras ready. In from the left-hand side, it's time for Tornado. As Red 1 faces up, the lights will be on towards us. The smoke will come on. 8-9 roll go will be the call.
8-9 roll go! Aboard!
Aboard calls 8 and 9 as the red and blue smoke comes on. 8 and 9 rolling around the rest of the formation. Red 1 about to bring the formation to the left with a change of smoke colour. This is Tornado. Smoke off go calls Red 9 as the aircraft finish Tornado and head away from us. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're approaching the first end of the first half of the display. Hopefully you're all enjoying it, but so far it's been those 9-ship graceful formation aerobatics. Well, as we head into the second half, we are about to up the tempo. We're about to shift up a gear as we enter the second half. Red 1 positioning out to crowd front. They've gone back into Phoenix formation. As they're coming back in towards us, he's about to split the formation down into the first group of five and the back four, including the synchro pair for the opposition passes. The front five aircraft are nicknamed Enid, after the British author Enid Blyton, who had a series of children's books named The Famous Five. Pointing at show center, the lights are on towards us. Red 1 about to give the command for the spectacular palm split. Red 1 pulling up 7 aircraft to the vertical. Red 6 and 7 staying flat. It's the palm split. As the palm tree develops above us, keep your eyes on Red 6 and 7. They're the ones staying low, pulling up ready for the first of their opposition maneuvers. Out to the right-hand side, we have Red 6 being followed by Red 8. Smoking out on the left is Red 7 being followed by Red 9. As the aircraft pull in towards us, they'll have a closing speed of over 700 miles an hour. They're going to drop down to 100 feet. They'll cross in front of us 100 feet apart, pulling up as they cross in the spectacular Jivo Pass. Reds 8 and 9 pull to the vertical as 6 and 7 4-point roll down the line. Keep your eyes on the low aircraft. They're pulling hard towards each other now. pulling 6 to 7 G. The nose light's about to come back on towards show center. They're going to reverse and cross in front of us, 100 feet apart in the Cyclone.
Cut!
As 6 and 7 flow away from us, they're pulling hard back in towards each other, about to cross smoke paths as they snip in the slingshot. Look out to your left, here comes Red 9 with the smoke on. Now look out to your right, we're looking for Enid. Here they come, the smoke's on. They're forming an inverted V formation. Red 9 about to fly straight down the middle in the goose. Red 9 pulling to the vertical is Flight Lieutenant Dan Lowe's. The red paint on his jet really standing out in the glorious skies over Gatineau. Red 1 leading the aircraft off to the left in Enid formation. The blue and red smoke about to change to white as we get ready for the next maneuver. Well, ladies and gentlemen, the next maneuver is dedicated to everybody here today that's come out to see the red arrows. Look straight ahead. We're looking for the nose lights of red 6 and 7 as they pull to the vertical, ready for the heart. Red 6 and 7 pulling over the top, the white smoke standing out in the glorious blue sky. Look up to the top right, in comes Red 8, his smoke comes on, ready to spear the heart. Ladies and gentlemen, dedicated to all of you in the audience, the heart and spear. As they complete the heart, red 6 and 7 smoke back on, pulling hard in towards each other. We've got red 6 on the right, red 7 on the left, again with a closing speed of over 700 miles an hour. Red 6 on our right about to roll inverted. They'll switch as they cross in vice versa. As 6 and 7 turn the smoke off and move off to the left and right, they're clearing the way for the next maneuver. In from the left-hand side, Red 1 has formed the other aircraft up together. The smoke is about to come on. The aircraft are about to pull up. Get those cameras ready for another spectacular shot. Red 1 pulling the aircraft, ready for the vertical break.
Right now. Hold on, sir. Back now.
Break, break, go, calls Red 1, it's the vertical break. As Red 1 turns the smoke off for the front section, it's time to look out for the synchro pair. In from the left and the right hand side, the smoke comes back on. The aircraft again pulling in down the line. A closing speed of 700 miles an hour. They're going to cross 3 times in front of us, changing smoke color as they go in the carousel. Red 6 and 7 with the red and blue smoke pulling 7G hard towards each other. As they cross at the back of the circle, they'll change color, leaving a blue and red half of the circle. White smoke comes back off, red 6 and 7 out to the left and right, leaving room for the next maneuver. Now look over to your front and to the right, the coloured smoke comes on, red 1 pulling Enid up to the vertical, starting 2 rolls to the left in a snake-like shape across the sky. It's time for the Python. Red 1 about to change smoke colour through his voice commands. Each aircraft has 5 minutes of white smoke, 1 minute of red and 1 minute of blue, selected by buttons on the pilot's control stick. As Red 1 enters the second of the snake-like barrel rolls to complete the Python, he'll turn the smoke off to make way for the next manoeuvre from the rear section.
Holding the bank now. Smoke off, go.
As the smoke goes off on our left-hand side, it's time to look out to our right. Here come the 4 aircraft from the rear section. Red 6 and 7 are about to roll inverted and fly down the line. Reds 8 and 9 will roll around them in the corkscrew. Aboard calls Red 9, the red and blue smoke comes on, 8 and 9 roll around 6 and 7. Complete, whispers Red 9 as they complete the corkscrew manoeuvre to our left hand side. Red 6 and 7 rolling the right way round to make way for Enid coming in from the left. Red's about to roll from the inside of the formation to the outside, changing smoke colour as they go in the rollbacks. 2 and 3 roll go, the signal for them to roll. Clear go, the signal for 4 and 5.
Clear, go! Clear, go! Complete!
Complete, sings Red 5 as the rollbacks finish to our right-hand side. Enid banking around, the white smoke on. Now look straight out to show center, out to the front. Here come the 4 lights of the back section. 8 and 9 rolling around, 6 and 7. 6 and 7 about to roll before splitting in the Gippo break. Keep your eyes on red 6 and 7 as they stay low, the coloured smoke changing to white as they prepare for the last of their opposition passes. This time on the left we have red 7, Flight Lieutenant John Bond. John is formally instructed on the Takano aircraft, he then flew the Typhoon and is in his second year on the team. For their final opposition pass, red 6 and 7. The height comes down. As they face up towards each other, they're going to pull up into opposition barrel rolls in the double rolls.
Thank you.
6 and 7 complete their double rolls. It is time for the show finale. Look straight ahead of you, out to show center. The 7 remaining lights come towards us. Red One preparing for the spectacle.
A familiar sight to you, I'm sure, but they're Canadian, I can tell you that as well.
It is a familiar sight. In fact, there were some amazing photos taken earlier on in Ottawa of the aircraft going over Parliament Hill and those very people, I believe, marching on the ground. So there isn't a more patriotic sight, I don't think.
No kidding. And you're about to, of course, as you began this tour in Halifax, you got to meet the folks at the lower deck and other great landmarks in Halifax, but the hospitality on the East Coast too. And then you're off to visit our American friends, Chicago, Boston, over the next little while, and the rest of this tour.
That's right. So Chicago is our next stop. But can I say first, what a great place to start our tour with our first public display here, but moving on to Chicago, and then we're off to Atlantic City, New York, and on throughout the US, and then we're visiting Canada again during the show, of course, to Toronto. So we're looking forward to seeing both sides of the border throughout the tour.
Outstanding, and we see the jet now going over there, and the band is about to play. We'll let that, and probably a great photo opportunity coming up, and your chance to meet over the next half hour or so after the shutdown, and I suppose a quick debrief, then the chance to meet the pilots.
Absolutely, so it's standard for us to debrief everything we do. We won't do a full debrief just now, we'll do a quick debrief on the wing, and then later on, either tonight or tomorrow, we will analyze the recording of our display, go into very fine detail, just so that we can strive to keep improving the display so that we give you a memorable, dynamic, but overall safe display.
Oh, quelle belle présentation, Rick. Bien entendu, ce qu'on disait, bien. Environ une trentaine de minutes, au lieu de vous rendre dans la circulation et d'être pris dans la circulation, on vous invite à rester avec nous. Vous voyez présentement le Hawks des Red Arrows qui est remorqué vers le hangar probablement des ailes d'époque du Canada. On a la fanfare de la colonne parlementaire également qui est là. Donc, on aura probablement une prestation dans les prochaines minutes et on nous dit que d'ici 30 minutes, aussitôt que les Red Arrows seront stationnés sur l'air statique, on va faire un rapide debriefing du spectacle qu'on vient de faire. Et dans environ une trentaine de minutes, les pilotes seront dans la foule, ils vous rencontreront. Donc, allez parler avec eux, discuter avec eux. C'est une façon sensationnelle de voir des gens qui ont réalisé leurs rêves. On a parlé d'inspirer, on a parlé également des métiers dans le domaine de la